I pull up, like, how you pull up?
Yo, what is up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. Welcome back to the vlog. It's Chris here again, and today we got something super crazy for you. We're on our way right now to pick up our newest GTR we just bought last week. It's getting shipped up here from Arizona. Just came in. I just got the call. We're about to leave right now. 2016 GTR, and it has 2,000 horsepower. So I won't say too much about it now. We'll let you guys check it out when we get there. It only should take a couple minutes. We're right down the street, so we'll see you guys then.
There it is, sitting up top. We'll pull around.
There she is, boys. Fresh off the truck. Oh, she's beautiful. 2,000 horsepower right there, boys. There she is, boys.
I hate to say it, guys. How cool, huh?
This thing looks sick. 16 got the front carbon fiber lip. These wheels are crazy.
So that's what 2,000 horsepower looks like.
Insane in here. They wrapped everything in carbon fiber in here.
The whole steering wheel redid, squared it off.
Look at these paddle shifters. Even the gauges are carbon fiber.
So this is what this bad boy looks like underneath the hood. I got the list here. I'm gonna be reading it off to you guys because we literally just bought it. I can't memorize the full list of this stuff that's in here. It's absolutely insane, all the mods that are done to this. We'll start with, right now it's at 1500 wheel horsepower, so nearing close to 2000 at the crank. It's got a lot of the Alpha 12 stuff in it. It's a AMS short block, up to like 1600 wheel capable motor. It's got the Alpha Spec Extreme, dual mainly I-beam rods, connecting rod, main amp thrust bearings. That was a $7,000 mod. It's got the Alpha Performance R35 GTR Race X one-piece billet flywheel, Kelford cams, 2.5 turbos, Garrett GTX 307, GR quick spool turbos, capable of 1500 wheel horsepower. That was 10,000. Trial QR BOV, Rampage Fab catch cam, ATI super damper pulley, etc., etc., etc. It goes on and on. I could go on for 30 minutes with what's done to this engine. It's absolutely insane. The full build equals about 165,000, and that's just the engine and the suspension. That's not the price of the car. So you throw in the price of the car with it, a 2016 GTR goes for about 70,000. So 160 plus 70, and there you go. It's around 230,000, a little over a quarter million worth it. And we got it, as you saw, for 115. So we were gonna build that whole other GTR out, and it was gonna cost about 140,000. So I just happened to find this, and we picked it up for a good deal, so we just decided to get this instead. Looks beautiful. The wrap he has on it is a pearl white. When the sun hits it right, it looks like you can see all the different rainbow colors in it. It's got crazy wheels. I gotta ask him about what wheels are on it again. These tires, he told me, are better than the Nittos. It's one of the best racing tire in the world, he was saying. It's got full titanium exhaust on it. Like, look how big these tips are. I can literally put my fist in this shit. And it just swallows my whole hand. He wrapped the carbon diffuser on the bottom. He did the full carbon fiber trunk, just glistening in the sun. Needs washed, but just came off the truck. What can you do? So it's gonna look even better than it looks right now once we give it a wash. Sitting real pretty next to my dad's 650S McLaren drop top, wrapped in a ton of carbon, absolutely beautiful. Let's go ahead and cut to a cinematic shot. I'm back in here in the GTR, about to start it up, take it for our first spin. Starts up nice.
carbon paddles here over the stock ones. They're huge. You can shift these in like any position of the steering wheel, which is pretty nice. The other ones is you can't do that. If your hands aren't like right here on the steering wheel, you're not gonna be able to shift. So that's pretty nice in case you need to downshift in the turn. Carbon everywhere throughout here. They even put carbon on the gauges. Looks so good. 10 out of 10. Now, all that's left is just to see how she drives. This is the most power I've ever been behind the wheel of, by far. The fastest car I had ever driven before this was the McLaren 720S. And with its tune, it was pushing about 900 horsepower. This is almost double that at the crank, so we gotta be extra careful here while we learn how to control this bad boy. Runs very smooth. You wouldn't know. This is what I was wondering a lot. Like, are you going to be able to tell when you're driving it that it has that kind of crazy power? And so far, no. It drives just like a normal car. Like, out here, just on the city streets, cruising along right about 40 miles an hour, and it's good. You can't tell it has that kind of crazy power. Let's see what it sounds like when we get on it a little bit, boys. Downshift here. Oh my gosh. Are you kidding? Oh shit. That was insane. That was third gear. And I barely got on it. Let's hit it again one more time. Holy shit. So that's what full titanium exhaust sounds like in person. That's crazy.
Haven't done my taxes, I'm too turned up. Virgil got a paddock on my wrist going nuts. Niggas caught me slipping once.
Just got back to the house. Just gave her a bath. If you guys enjoyed this vlog, if you did, leave a like. Remember to subscribe, comment down below. We got another car coming in about 3 days. You guys leave a comment down below. Take a guess on what it is. It's gonna blow your guys' mind. So stay tuned. Bitch, this is fame, not clout. I don't even know what that's about. Watch your mouth. Baby got an ego twice the size of the crib.